Hey guys, what is up? Reaper here, and today I am doing a video I don't normally do, and you know, these are videos that I'd like to do more of. I just don't have the time because of my shitty day job, but you know, I get to them when I can, and this one in particular is very important to me just because of the fact that I am in the Battlefield 1 Alpha, if the footage in front of you wasn't a clear, obvious thing. Now, I'm going to preface this video by saying that, first off, I absolutely fucking love this game. It is a blast to play. I'm having a ton of fun, even though I get a little rage face. There is no commentary with this footage, except for whatever you're listening to right now. So you won't be hearing me go all crazy on people and stuff like that. However, I will say this. I'm not a pro, so don't expect anything amazing in this footage. I will be dying a lot, just because, I don't know, I feel like there's a lot of things that definitely need to be changed, and of course, you know, this would not be an alpha or, you know, any kind of test if my cons list wasn't bigger than my pros list. So there's a lot of things that I think can definitely be changed. So we're going to go through the pros and cons to start off, just to, you know, get things rolling here. Definitely going to start with the pros because it's a much shorter list. It's like beep. And and then later on, we're going to go into the classes. I'm just going to go over the classes a little bit, you know, what I think about them, each one in particular, so on and so forth. And then and that'll be the video. And hopefully it won't be a very long video. It shouldn't be. I'm going to try and just run through these things as we go along. All right, to start off, I got to say, this is a gorgeous looking game. It's like Battlefield 4 and Star Wars Battlefront had a baby and shit this game out in a good way. It's absolutely phenomenal looking, even on ultra settings on PC. I do have to say that my computer, I've told you guys a million times what my computer consists of in terms of hardware. It is a beefy computer. And I think, you know, we're just We're obviously in an alpha, so it's going to be a bit rough around the edges. So running this game on ultra 1080p, I'm not getting a consistent 60 frames per second, but I'm not alone. You know, I think Nvidia users tend to have a bit of a better time with everything, but I'm not alone. Everything seems to be pretty much aligned with, you know, other people's problems. Digital Foundry kind of like confirmed that for me. But the best part about this is, I think if you're going to play this game in any format, PC would be the way to go. Not because I've grown to be a PC enthusiast over the years, but because you're going to get the best experience possible visually. PC can play at whatever resolution you have for a monitor, whereas the PS4 is locked in at about 900p, and the Xbox One, the most inferior system of them all, is locked in at 720. These could change later on, but all in all, they're still lower than PC. You're still going to get a better visual experience on PC, and as you can see from the footage, it looks amazing. This is in 1080p 30 frames per second. I can't record in 1080p 60. I'm sorry. I wanted to do 720p 60, but 1080p is the best visual quality that I could possibly give you, so please just bear with me. The musical score in this game is absolutely just gorgeous. I love it. You get this really cool swooping score when you go when you go to spawn in, and the camera swoops down to your character and you start off the battle. It's awesome. It makes the whole thing feel epic, and it makes you feel like really good, like really pumped for battle. You know, and of course there's another score that plays when the game is about to end. I think most Battlefields tend to have something like that. However, this one seems a bit rushed because it starts to come in at about 180, 175 tickets out of 200. So I think it's a little bit too early to activate that score, but it's a really good score to listen to either way. I don't know if they're going to change it with the final release, where if you're losing, you'll have a different score as opposed to the team that's winning. Maybe if you're on the winning team, it'll be a more epic score, whereas, you know, the losing team gets more like, you know, sad and downtrodden type of score. But either way, the music, once again, they've outdone themselves with the music. It's a fine orchestration, and I absolutely love it. One of the mechanics that I've been longing to have back in Battlefield is finally back, in my opinion, with a minor tweak, but either way, it's back in. The Battlefield Bad Company 2 revive system is back. Now, if you know what I mean by that, good. But if you don't, I'm just going to quickly explain it to you. You stick somebody with a needle in this game. In other games, it's a, you know, defibrillator, paddles. You hit them with that, they're popping up. Just up, ready to go. And that was absolutely the best revive system ever. Whereas it's just like in Battlefield 4, you have to hit yes or no. It's like, why give me that option? Just get me up and going again. It was such an annoying thing to have in the games, and I'm so happy that they brought back that, you know, quick revive system. It's just bam, 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 get me back into the game. One of the biggest things that I think is definitely really good and kind of emphasizes that whole idea of, you know, team play is no more ticket bleed. And what that is basically, in prior Battlefields, you would capture points, your ticket numbers would go down, or the enemy team tickets numbers would go down or whatever. It not only capturing the points would do that, but also getting kills. That no longer happens. As a matter of fact, the counter is reversed and it goes up. And so the longer you hold the points, the more points you get. And kills actually no longer count towards that, which is fine by me, because you can rack up as many kills as possible, as long as you're playing the game and getting the objectives. This could be a potential issue, you know, making games more about, yeah, not really getting any kills and you're not really leveling up, but you do get a significant amount of points for capturing the spots, and it doesn't matter who's there first. You capture the spot, you get, I think, 500 points for capturing the spot, and you get 50 points for like every second that you're on that spot, taking it away and capturing it for your team. I just think it's good. I think that's perfect for team play, and I kind of hope that they keep that way. And of course, as always, DICE is always outdoing themselves when it comes to their sound engine. It's absolutely phenomenal. I can't imagine how they keep doing this. Every single iteration of one of their games, doesn't really matter, even from Battlefield 4 to Star Wars Battlefront, the sound engine somehow improved between two different types of games. I don't know how they did it, but it absolutely blew me away. And once again, they've done an amazing job on the sound. All the guns, all the explosions, all the vehicles, everything sounds phenomenal. And I can only imagine it getting even better as the game gets closer and closer to release, because it's probably not at its best right now, which is kind of surprising because it's fucking amazing to listen to. So I gotta give props again to DICE for their amazing work in the sound department. You guys rock. Okay, so now we're going to get into the cons. Like I said, it was a very short pros list, but there's a lot to fix in this game. So, you know, what are you going to do? It's an alpha. It's got to happen. So I'm going to try and go through the cons list as quickly as possible. I'm trying to keep the description or my explanation of each one to a somewhat minimum. The first one we're going to get into is, in my opinion, I think we need to limit class numbers per team. I mean, it's getting ridiculous to a point where we have... This actually came about more or less just because I am constantly... It's a very open map, and I'm constantly getting sniped. Not even just by snipers, but by medics who wield the DMRs. It's just hard to go across open ground without getting shot at by three different directions. And it's kind of getting annoying. And, you know, it's nothing different from the prior Battlefields. I think it just keeps carrying over and over and over. I think, personally, that they need to limit the amount of classes, of certain classes, per team. You know, in a game of 64, allow maybe a total of, I don't know, 5 snipers or something like that. So it can't just be spammed, you know. Limit a certain number of assault guys and medics, and let's try and even things out a little bit, you know. Limit one sniper per squad or something like that. Let's have some sort of limitation here, because then everybody's just going to be taking advantage of the sniper class and really just having at it, and it's just not going to be any fun for anybody to play. Another big thing is there's too much armor. Now, that's not necessarily saying that the armor is overpowered. Absolutely the opposite. I think the assault class does a fantastic job at taking down armor, but there's too much of it. When you first spawn into the game, on your home spawn point, before the game starts, when you spawn in, you get 2 tanks and 3 armored cars. That's a lot to start off with. And those armored cars are actually pretty fast. So you can go from, like, say, if you're on the German side, you start at Alpha Point or Apples, and you take one of those armored cars, you can go right across to Charlie or... No, Charlie. It's called Charlie. You can go right across to Charlie and cap it almost immediately. Or you can go all the way up to Edward or Echo and capture that. And the only reason I'm saying these different words is because that's how they used to call them, or that's what they used to call them back in World War One. You know, it was Apples, Butter, Charlie, Duff, Edward, and Freddy. It was weird, but it's what they had back in the day. But anyway, there's just too much armor, and you know, that's just the start. When you, most of the points on the map, when you capture those points, more armor spawns in, whether it be a tank or it be a armored car. Something spawns in on just about every single point in the game when you capture it. So you're just, you know, gathering up more armor and more armor. And I thought, I was under the impression that armor was going to be less but more effective. And so I don't understand what their mentality was when they decided to design it this way, but I really hope that they change it up so that way there's not all this armor running around, because then it's really hard to be an infantryman in this game, and you're kind of required to be in armor, and I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be stuck in a tank for the entire game. One of the major things that I think is very, very strange to me is the game has some weird spawn points. Like, if you want to spawn in on Delta, you go to hit the spawn point, not like on your partner or anything, but you go to hit the spawn point, it'll pick one of like 50 different spawn points that are around it. Rarely will you actually spawn inside the point, like actually on Delta. Most of the time you're spawning out in the middle of a field that's close to it, quote unquote close, but it's like in the open field, and it's pure cannon fodder. Basically, you can either get shot by a tank, or you can get sniped, or you can get shot in the back by somebody just happening to be running up in that direction. And so it's just like, it's kind of an inconvenient situation for you to be in, to spawn in like that in the middle of an open field. I think they need to tweak the spawn point system a little bit. When you go into spawn on a point, you should be a lot closer to that point so that you can defend it better. You know, I understand their mentality. If the enemy team is actually inside the point, spawning on the outside, you'll be able to get them easier, but you're a much easier target to see. So I think they need to switch it. This is very nitpicky. This is a nitpicky thing, but the continue screen, when you finish a round and you go to continue, if you don't actually hit the continue button, sometimes it'll overlap the next screen, which is your, you know, class choosing screen. The last couple times I played the game, it seemed to be fixed, but it's also, you know, it could still be there, but yeah, it kind of just overlaps the class selection screen if you don't hit continue. And then, of course, on that continuation screen, there's supposed to be, like, the portraits of people who did certain things in those games, in that particular game, like the highest score and stuff like that. Sometimes that doesn't even pop up. So that's, again, that's a little nitpicky thing, but I mean, so sue me. I used to be a game tester. You know, I'm going to be very picky about certain things. As is with any Battlefield, the kill cam is too fucking long. I'm sick of staring at the same asshole who killed me 2 seconds ago for the next 1 minute. Like, it's the kill cam is too long. They need to shorten it up. Just show me who it is for 5 seconds. 5 seconds. That's all I need. Maybe even less than that. 2 seconds. Just show me who it is and then let me get back in the game. I don't need to be staring at the kill cam longer than I need to. It's annoying. And it's been in the game since Battlefield whenever. You know, I remember back in Battlefield 3. Hell, even Bad Company 2. I recently played that. The kill cam was still kind of long. And they've never changed it. You don't have to take it out, but make it shorter. It's bullshit. Let me get back in the game. I'm sick of sitting there waiting for myself to stop looking at the guy who killed me. It's annoying. Just take it out. Just take it down to about 2 seconds. That's all I need. 2 seconds, see the guy's name, I'll go in and kill him, okay? Don't make it any longer than that. They seem to have, you know, kept this from Battlefield 4, but the spotting system, I still think, needs improvement. I mean, why should my crosshairs be over the guy exactly in order to spot him? You know, and half the time when I think my crosshairs are on him and I'm smashing the Q key to, to spot the guy, it doesn't seem to work. So I'm just like, it definitely needs improvement, but they really need to not follow suit with Battlefield 4. Because they changed it up to where, like, if you had the guy in the vicinity of your crosshairs, like, not exactly on him, but, like, somewhere in the scope or whatever, it would spot the guy, because you can fucking see it. But, you know, now, later on, during Battlefield 4's lifespan, they changed it to be, you have to literally have your crosshairs on it. It's getting ridiculous. Please don't do that. Just make it in general vicinity. If you see the guy, let us spot him. Just make it accurate. This next one goes kind of hand in hand. Two of these things go hand in hand with each other. I feel like the bullet damage is a bit weird. SMGs do massive amounts of damage while LMGs do like no damage at all. I mean, maybe that's just me, and maybe I just had a poor connection with whatever server. I was playing on the US East server, so I don't know how I could possibly have a poor connection with a 16 ping. But I feel like the damage models for the guns are a bit off. SMGs, I understand, supposed to just completely tear me apart in close quarters. I don't care. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is the SMGs being able to kill me from medium-ish range, where they're supposed to be out of range, and they kill me in like two hits. I don't understand it. Even a headshot, like if they get a headshot and a body shot, I'm dead with an SMG. And I was under the impression that these were supposed to be close quarters weapons only. You know, about medium range is where their effective range is. So, like, I shouldn't be getting killed at that kind of a range with something as small as a MP18. It doesn't make any sense to me. It's actually kind of annoying, actually. So, you know, I'd like, and from what I understand in World War One, you know, LMGs were a new thing, mostly mounted machine guns, but to run around with a Lewis gun was still possible, and I'm pretty sure they shot bigger bullets. You know, just like today's LMGs, they shoot bigger bullets than standard, you know, assault rifles, especially bigger than SMGs. So why the Lewis gun does considerably less damage than an SMG makes no sense to me whatsoever. And I think this needs to be tweaked a little bit. I just got a problem with that, you know, having that problem. You'll see it in the clips. I'm getting killed a lot by SMGs. It's kind of annoying. Another thing that's quite annoying is getting hung up on terrain. There's some geometry in the world that, like, you know, you go to vault over something and he won't vault over it. And then you're just running from point A to point B, and all of a sudden just a small piece of, you know, the terrain, or if like you go into a ditch and expect to smoothly go up the hill, you get stuck. And it kind of breaks the game a little bit, you know, it breaks your momentum, and that's never good, you know, especially if you're on a good run or something like that, and all of a sudden just a piece of wood on the ground stops you in your tracks. That can't happen. And so I'm kind of hoping that they're still working on that, and that they're able to iron out all the details, especially with the vaulting. The vaulting is a big issue with me. Because, you know, I don't know if I'll be able to get some of the footage in here, but if I do, you'll see that sometimes I go to vault over a wall that essentially is vaultable. Like, you can vault over that wall, and he just won't. He'll do the animation, he'll go up on the rock, but he'll just slide right back down, and hopefully that's something that they'll fix. That's got to be something that they'll fix by the time the game releases. I'm sure they've got enough information as it is. Now, this thing I felt pretty good about to begin with, but then I felt not so good after that. When I heard that you were actually going to be able to stay off the mini-map, even when you fire your weapon, because, I mean, suppressors didn't exist, so, you know, you're never going to be able to hide yourself. You're always going to be showing up on the minimap, and so people are always going to know where you are. So essentially, staying off the minimap even while you fire is actually kind of a nice thing. However, it literally creates the ultimate cheese tactic of camping. I feel like I'm playing a hardcore match every single time, because all you get are these assholes who like to camp. All they do is just sit in a corner, or, you know, just stay in one spot. And yeah, okay, I get the kill cam and I can see them. But if they're in a good spot and I'm just being all kinds of stupid and having a bad day of aiming or whatever the case may be, they're going to pick me off every single time, even when I go out and try to get them back. And so not being able to see them on the minimap unless somebody has physically spotted them is extremely cheesy. It just employs the worst kind of tactics that people tend to employ. And I just feel like I said, I feel like I'm in a giant hardcore match every single game I play. So I'm not sure if this is such a good idea, but that's just me. Maybe people just need to get better at spotting, because, you know, I feel like I'm the only one who's always spotting. But, you know, maybe people will get used to it. Maybe they won't. Maybe it'll be the biggest cheese tactic ever, and this game will have... It will be hindered by that, in my opinion. I just feel like it... They gotta tweak it somehow. Something's gotta give, because that is just something that's so wrong. I touched on this a little bit earlier, about the visual aspect of the game. It's a gorgeous game on ultra settings. Everything's cranked all the way up. 1080p, it looks amazing. But if you guys will see, I've got the frame rate counter in the top corner there. You can see that I've locked it in at 45 frames per second. Now, I can do that because AMD Radeon settings actually have the frame rate control for it, and just like Nvidia has their own. And so I wasn't able to get a consistent frame rate. You know, even I dropped the graphics down to medium, which is well below the capabilities of my graphics card. And even then, when I looked out into the open fields, it was a smooth 60. When I looked over towards the village, it dropped as low as 40 frames per second. And so that's a big difference, especially when you're trying to get a smooth, consistent experience. And so what I did was I capped it off myself at 45 frames a second, and I had the smoothest experience that I've ever had in my life. Obviously, you guys can't see it because the video itself is in 30 frames per second, but, you know, you can see it up in the top right corner. It's there. The proof is in the pudding. I had to cap it at 45 frames a second just to have a consistent experience. Now, it's got a lot of optimization to go through, but my gripe is that, once again, AMD is kind of getting shafted here. I don't know who to blame, whether it's AMD or DICE, but all the footage that I see coming from Level Cap, Jack Frags, Matimio, they all have consistent frame rate. Maybe not steady 60 frames a second, but, you know, at EA Play, I'm sure they had amazing machines to run the game on, and it was a different build of the game. I know for a fact that Level Cap has an amazing machine, and I guess I can see these guys not having too much of an issue running the game, you know, getting upwards of 60 frames a second and not really dropping anywhere below 50, but still, I feel like Nvidia is being favored once again, even though, you know, Battlefield 4 featured the Mantle API. I still feel like Nvidia is getting, you know, favored over this, and I feel like AMD is just getting shit on once again. And so I hope things turn around, and I really hope that it's just the alpha that's doing this and that I'm not the only one. Like I said earlier, according to Digital Foundry, they couldn't get a consistent 60 FPS. So I'm kind of hoping that this is just the alpha and it's not favoritism. I'm not the only one that is bothered by this. Planes not blowing up on impact. I don't understand why that's not implemented. I guess they're still working on the animations, maybe. But when a plane hits the ground and just bounces, that's kind of fucking weird. It breaks the sense of immersion. It certainly breaks the game a little bit, because then people can dive bomb you physically and then go back up. That happened to me. I don't know if it's in this footage, but it happened to me one time where a guy was just, I guess, couldn't hit us with his guns. And so what did he do? He dive bombed us, literally with his plane, killed me, and then flew away. Like, I don't know what to say to that. I really hope that gets fixed. They've got to have those animations in there, in the final product. It just wouldn't make sense to not have them blow up. I don't give a shit if these planes weren't made of metal back then. We know they were made of wood, but wood breaks pretty easily. So, you know, it's not like a baby. It doesn't bounce. So here's hoping that they fix those in the final product. I'm going to do my best not to include this in the footage, because I don't want to give anybody epileptic seizures. But there's a weird green flicker every once in a while. I'm not sure what happens. But it happens at different points on the map, in the game. I don't know if you'll see it in this footage. It's fucking weird. I don't know what causes it, but sometimes when I'm looking over at Objective Edward, it just happens. And in one specific direction, like every other direction is fine, but if I look in that specific direction, this weird green tint comes over the screen, and it's just it kind of, boy, does it fuck with your mind. It's weird. This is just a little again a little nitpick thing. The lean prompt appears for no reason. Even when I'm just like running out in the open, the lean prompt for some reason just appears. I think that's just a very minor issue. I'm sure they're going to fix it eventually. But I just thought I'd point that out if you guys aren't seeing it on screen already. Over on the right side, you'll see the lean prompt just come up every once in a while, and it's just very strange. And I'll be out in the open running, sprinting, and that'll just show up. So I don't know. That's a nitpick. And last but not least with the cons, I feel like the bullet hit is inconsistent, and what I mean by that is when I'm shooting my gun, I'm shooting the guy, I have my crosshairs on him, I know I should be hitting him, and I know I'm not bad at aiming, I'm not this bad at aiming, but there's a lot of the time where I feel like my bullets just don't hit the character. Now that could be just due to simple fact that of my connection compared to that person, or my connection to the server, or their connection to the server, whatever the case may be. Wherever the inconsistency happens, it happens nonetheless. And I always seem to be, I don't know if I'm the only victim of it, but I feel like a lot of the time my bullets just kind of go through people. And that, again, I might be another nitpick, I don't know. But all I can say is that it sucks. And I'm just like, I should be hitting this guy! You know, it's one of those moments where you pull your hair out. I mean, if I had hair on my head, I'd pull it out. But it's still... it's annoying not to be able to shoot somebody and know that you're supposed to kill them, and they just come around the corner and blast you in the face with a shotgun or something. So, I don't know. Again, another nitpick thing, and I'm sure it'll be fixed later on. Maybe even in the beta, it'll be fixed. But you better believe I'll be doing another one of these videos at beta time. So... We'll see what happens with all these fixes. But I think that's actually going to do it for this video, guys. I went a lot longer than I thought. I'm going to split this up. I'll do the classes video another time a little bit down the road. That'll be after this one. I think this is a good video in its own right. I probably should have just thought about that a second ago. I have to get notes on the classes anyway, you know, like weapons and gadgets and stuff like that, just to be a little bit more consistent and a little bit more informational. But I really hope that this video kind of puts into perspective of what my experience of the game has been so far. And again, thank God the NDA was actually lifted, because I could not wait to start telling people about this game and showing footage and streaming it and all this other stuff. But I really hope this kind of gives you guys an idea as to what the game is like at the moment. Please take away from this that it is purely my opinion. Do know that this game is fun as dicks. It is so much fun to play, and I honestly cannot wait for the the final product. It's such a refreshing thing to go backwards in time and play with the older weapons and the older equipment and stuff like that. But I really hope that that you guys get something from this, kind of formulate your own opinions. And if you do, don't be afraid to put them down in the comments down below. If you have played in the alpha, let me know what your thoughts are on each one of these points in the game. You know, all the things that I feel need to be fixed or changed or whatever. If you feel as though the spotting system is on point, let me know why. If you think that the bullet damage is just fine for each gun, tell me. I'd like to know. I'd like to get some conversation going. But that is going to do it for this video today, guys. I'd like to thank you all for joining me. And please join me again in the next video, where we'll be discussing the classes of the game and their suitable weapons, and particularly which classes I feel are the most effective and which ones I feel are just kind of there. And please don't forget to check the links in the video description below for all of the social media stuff that I have. Check out my website, where all of my main content is actually hosted, from the live stream to my main YouTube shows, Blitzkrieg and Heroes of the Storm. And absolutely, please check the link for the charity I'm trying to raise money for. We're still $98 short. I gotta reach that $200 goal, and it's only gonna be because of you guys. Let's help these kids out. Let's get these kids the money that they deserve to live a healthier, happier life. And I want my damn t-shirt. That's all I'm playing for right now is a t-shirt. I want to help these kids and I want to get my damn t-shirt. So please help me out. I don't know. It's not like I don't have shirts, but you know, it's a nice shirt. I want a nice shirt. You know, if I can help kids out in the, you know, at the time that I'm actually going to get a nice shirt to go along with it, I'll do that. What do you want? I paid $15 for it. I kind of want it, but I got to raise that money first. So please, 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 if you can give, any amount helps. If you can't, don't worry. We're going to get there. I promise. This year, we will hit that goal. But until next time, guys, I'm Reaper. This is Battlefield 1, and don't forget to subscribe.